I'm really happy to be here. When you say fitness and health for me are very integral to me. I mean, please don't go with the body that I have. That takes a lot of hard work. But I'm talking about being healthy and happy from within. And somebody said this to me a while back. It's not a crash diet. It's not just what you want to achieve in a stimulated time frame. It becomes a way of life. And I think that's what I completely agree and resonate when Swiss comes here and says that it's a quest. Because when you make it a part of your lifestyle, it becomes a way of your living. You have to naturally start loving what you eat, being healthier, feeling happier, and it will show on you. And that's one journey and quest that I have been on for quite a few years, from the time that I fell in love with what I eat, how I kind of make myself feel healthier and happier with my lifestyle, with food, with exercise. It's a whole thing. And it's become a very, very integral part of who I am today. And this is why when something as, when you say natural ingredients and when you say that that's what's going to be incorporated in your lifestyle, I'm 100% going up there and buying that product. Only because we want to go back to natural resources and try and tap into that. And I love Australia. I think my love affair with Australia started with MasterChef Australia. I started watching it on television and I just couldn't get over that show because they kept talking about natural produce. And I think on a larger scale, when you eat healthy and right, that's what's going to make you feel healthier from within. And I'm just really happy that you guys have chosen to come to India because the market here has opened up to a completely different lifestyle in terms of food. When you go to a restaurant, you'll have a separate menu, which is your vegan menu or your diet menu or your healthy produce menu. You can definitely go to a nice sort of gym and they'll give you another set of sort of regimes and food to kind of follow. So the market right now in India is absolutely correct for you to bring this product here because your multivitamins are going to help everybody who's trying to make a nice and healthier lifestyle and body. And also your food and your beauty, which is always going to be there. So I think I'm glad you guys are here and we have another avenue and source to kind of bring this in our lifestyle. And I'm going to be your consumer for sure. Even if you don't have this e-commerce very, very reaching a lot of audiences, I'm going to reach out for it for sure. So come and let's chat.
Michelle, tell me about your career, as you first developed. How did you prioritize your own health and wellness? Because I know I'm not in your industry, of course, but I know that when you're building your career, it's so sometimes you just get so single-mindedly focused on what you want to achieve at work. But actually,
when you're an actor, and that's just the little bit of a hazard when you are being in this competitive industry, because they're going to judge you by the way you look. So your physical appearance becomes your top selling point. And I think I understood that over a few years, that it's not what you look on the outside. Because if you're not going to be healthy within, the look on the outside is going to fade really fast. That's a little bit of a myth that I think people, when they say we are healthy, they're not able to crack. Because it's not the fit body that is always going to keep you healthy. I think it's what you are within that keeps you healthy. And for me, that was a journey. Because when I started as an actor, there were a lot of people telling me things, what to do, how to kind of build it, how to make it. But you have to discover it for yourself. And each body is completely unique. What works on me might not work on you. What works on you doesn't work on me. So for me, health, fitness has been a personal journey at first. Where I had to discover what really works for me, what looks good on me, what makes me better. And I stuck to that. And that became my sort of fitness regime. And it's become a lifestyle, yeah. It's become a way of life, I think. I don't think I know how to live another way now.
So tell me about your regime. What do you do? What do you like? And how has it changed over the last few years?
I think I like a mix of everything. I don't like to overwork my body or myself, whether it's physically or mentally. Because sometimes when I'm not mentally in the right place, no matter how much I spend time in the gym, it's not going to really help.
You don't like cardio, or you don't even go really hard on the gym?
I really like doing cardio, but I put in cardio in a form of a game. So I'll play badminton with my parents for 4 hours. That's my cardio. So if I don't go to the gym, I'm on the court playing badminton. So suddenly you're playing a game, your mind is more occupied, you're more energetic, you're not just walking on a treadmill, you know? So I think, now that's something I discovered for myself. It could work, it could be something else. Somebody could go for a run and feel really happy after a run because I think I've seen this with people, when they go for a run, they come home not tired but energized to start the day all over again, you know. So I think for me, a regime got set into place with how I feel with that exercise. So if I don't feel like I'm in the gym, I'll probably go play like 4 hours of badminton. And I don't even know where the 4 hours have gone. I've just been playing. So that's one. I like to get my sleep in. I have to have my sleep. If I'm not able to catch sleep in the night, then I'll take a nap in the afternoon. But I really need to get those 8 hours of sleep. Water is very, very important. I think that's actually a problem with me. I forget to drink water. So I have people reminding me to kind of keep drinking water, keep myself hydrated.
And about nutrition, what do you focus on? Do you follow any particular diets or not so much diets, but type of, you know, way of life?
I don't think a diet is something that I could honestly keep to, and I really don't think a diet works on a larger, like on a longer scale. I mean, it could get you short-term results, but if you have to sustain it on a larger time frame, then a diet doesn't help. You just have to become that. So for me, I eat home-cooked food. My mom makes great food, guys, and I think that's what I would really advocate, because it's healthy, it's natural, it's made from all the food that your mom goes and buys from the market, and she's made it with all the love and care. And of course, she looks over all the fat that's not there, so there's very little oil, there's very little salt, very little sugar, but it's still home cooked food. That's my go-to food. I eat that, and I definitely go to the gym. But if not a gym, then I don't act. So either it's sports or So this is my day. I do play around. I keep changing.
And I've heard you're into Pilates. How did that come about?
Pilates, another journey. See, so again, if I kept myself open to it, I discovered it. I went to a couple of sessions with my trainer, and I was amazed at the effort it takes. It looks really simple and easy, but when you get onto that machine, it really makes you cry, because it makes you work out certain body muscles and parts that you didn't even know existed. That, oh, that's what's getting worked out. So Pilates, again, completely made me feel, when I walked out of Pilates, I had a different walk, because I worked out muscles I had not even really known existed. So that was my love for Pilates. I mean, if, for example, I don't play badminton, then those 2 days in a week, I'll go to a Pilates session. So I kind of put a mix of things in it, so that my body is really, it's always shocked. Okay, oh, now she's doing Pilates, now she's playing 4 hours of badminton. Okay, now she's only doing weights. So I do a mix of things, yeah.
And when you think about your own personal quest, I mean, you've been in the Bollywood industry for how many years now?
Can I say that?
Yeah, you do. It's impressive. It's so impressive.
You're younger than you are, for sure.
So tell me about your journey, you know, in the industry, and how, you know, your quest has developed, I guess, your own personal journey.
I think, you know, being an artist is a very unique sort of being. I don't know how to explain it, but you dream of such things at such young ages, where you feel ki ye sapna sach hoga. I'm sorry, but this dream come true, and then you feel like, you know, I can see it happening even if the world can't. And at that point, people might kind of say that you're really ambitious, but I stuck to it. I don't know why. I remember somebody asked me to do a small part in a film, and I said, you know, I don't want to do that small part, I want to do the leading girl's part. And I was quite young, I was in college, so people laughed at me when I said that really, you think you're going to do the lead? And I said, yeah, why not? And bam, a few years later, I was doing the lead. So I don't know how these things kind of put into, how they come into action, but I never stopped dreaming, I never stopped being ambitious. And that's one thing I like about being an artist, that it's never ending. I don't think you ever reach a place where you say, this is it, I'm done. Exactly. There's always striving to get to something better, something new, being somewhere else. And that sort of keeps me at it every day. I feel like there's something new I want to be today, and somewhere new I want to get to today. And that is what really fuels me. And
that's quite a mindfulness approach, isn't it?
It's completely
focusing on a goal, visualizing it.
It's passion, I think. I think it's passion. I don't think I'd be here if I wasn't passionate enough with anything I do, whether it's dancing, whether it's acting, whether it's coming to an event like this, where I'm really glad that all these people are here and I'm saying this, and I feel it, you know. I feel like it drives, something from within drives me to kind of be this. And I'm glad that I'm at a place where what I think and feel resonates with so many people. And with that comes great responsibility. So I'm very, very careful also. But I'm glad that responsibility kind of is able to influence people in the right way. And I hope in this case, I'm able to drive people to a little more healthier and happier lifestyle.
Absolutely. Yeah. Now at Swiss, we're Australia's leading wellness company. We've been in operation for 50 years now, and our entire philosophy is built around mind, movement and nutrition. So keeping your mind healthy, your body healthy, and then also making sure you're eating really well.
Good.
So yeah, what do you think about that? How, as a holistic approach?
I think keeping your mind healthy is being happy. And honestly, nothing out there can make you happy but yourself. And that's something I've just discovered, not now, but a while back. So I keep myself happy, which is why if I want to play badminton, I'll play badminton and I'll be happy. If I want to go to a Pilates session, I'll go to a Pilates session and be happy. Hell, for one event, if I don't want to look in shape and I'm a little fat, I'm happy. You know what I'm saying? As long as I'm mentally happy, I'm able to kind of do this. I'm able to be this. And you'll never see me stressed or worried about something. And that, I think, shows on my face and body. Just because these people are not listening to me. इसके अगर दिमाग सही है, happy है, तो पूरी body भी दिखता है, and that's exactly my complete mantra of life.